welcome to our quick introduction to pin warp. And you'll find pin warp in the warp category, and pin warp allows us to warp specific image areas using pins whilst leaving other areas untouched. And it's useful for doing more sort of subtle body reshaping or face reshaping, as we're going to do in this exercise, or something more obvious like repositioning an arm or leg. But let's take a look at how we start to work with it. So I'm going to find an appropriate frame. Let's find this frame here, and I'm going to apply my pin warp. If we look at the no parameters to start with, we don't have any parameters to work with at all. And that's because we need to interactively create our pins in the viewer. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to click and drag. I can move my source and my target pin interactively in the viewer. And if I hold down the control key or command key on Mac, I can adjust the range that this pin is going to be affecting. And to even things out a little bit, I'm just going to make a comparable move on the opposite side of the face. And let's take a quick look at the before and after there. So we can see we're pushing both sides of the face in now. And let's say I wanted to open up the eyes a little bit more. All I'd have to do is do the same things we did previously. So I'm going to move one pin warp from underneath the eye and then move one above a little bit there and do the same thing on the opposite side as well. And if I hold down the control key here, let's just limit the range of these new ones that we've created. And let's make that even more pronounced now. There we go. Now, sometimes you might want to have areas that you want to be left unaffected by this pin warp, and that's easy to do as well. If I click without dragging or double click, I'll create a tack. And a tack defines an area that we want to remain unaffected, in this case, the nose. And again, I'll just hold down control just to change the size of the area of influence there. And you can see if I move in the before and after that our nose remains the same, unaffected by the warping around it. Now, if we want this effect to be animated, all of our pins can be keyframed, or we can use a tracker, as I have here. I've got a planar tracker created that's tracking in the face. Just zoom out a little bit there so we can see that a bit better. And what I can do is I can attach this tracker to the pin warp. And it makes a bit more sense to apply the tracker before we make any of these pins, because as soon as I go to transform and set it to the layer that I've tracked, in this case the face tracked, all of our pins are going to shift. But if I had my tracker placed in first, this wouldn't make a difference. And in fact, that's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to delete all the pins I've created already and just set my tracker in to begin with before I make the changes that we did previously. If I want to make any of these other pins attack at a later date, I can just right click on them and make that attack there, or remove a pin simply on the viewer here. So let's take a little look at this before and after. Lovely. And because I've got this transformed into a track, those changes are going to move around along with that track as well. So before, and after. The only change I'd make here is to the position of the nose tack, and that's easy to do. So I can just set a keyframe here, scrub along where it goes out of place, and just move it over. And it really is as simple as that. And that's a quick look at the pin warp node.